Hi, this is Uma Mahesh from CRM Ones. In this video, I'm going to explain how to execute that TL SQL queries on CDS or CRM online database in Power Platform. The Microsoft recently released that Power Platform 2020 Wave 1. In that, one of the greatest feature is connecting the CDS Dynamics 365 database from SSMS. Earlier, if you want to query that CDS or CD cloud database, the only option we have is we need to dump the data into the our SQL database by using that SSIS Kingsway or Scribe or data export services solution we have to configure. But now we can able to directly we can connect with the CRM online database from SQL to set up this to connect to the CRM online database from your SQL studio management. So we have to do that some prerequisites. So the CDS environment, CDS means like a common data service, or it's a CRM version, should be like a 9.1.0.17437. That's version, or earlier it's like a higher version. Higher version that needs to be enabled, and you need to enable that TDS endpoint for CDS by using the Power Platform administration, and the SQL Server Studio management studio should be like a 18.4 or higher version. The only we have like a the querying the data from CDS database, we will able to we can able to do only read only, so we will not able to perform any insert and update permission. And that security, so whatever the CRM security you have, that same security will apply for the SQL queries also. Whatever the entity you have, like a read privilege, that same tables we can able to queries here. I will explain later how we can do that. To start configuring that TDS endpoints, let me open that my environment. We need to go to the admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. So once you log into that to enable that TDS endpoint. So you can see that list of your environments. So you can click on here on the environments, you can see the list of the environments. So my CRM environment is this one. So I'm just opening this environment here. So similarly, in your case, like you can see that which environment you want to connect to that. So you need to open that environment. And in the top, you can see the settings. So click on the settings. And once you click on the settings, you can see the product here. Click on the product. And once you click on the product, you can see the features in the below. So click on the features. And if you scroll down, you can see that these are the latest preview features or actual real-time implementation features, which you can enable it here. So if you scroll down, you can see the CDS endpoint preview. So at present, this CDS endpoint is like a preview feature. So that in the next coming versions, they may be giving that full feature version. So as of now, I'm enabling here. And once you click on enable, in the below, you can see the save. Once you click on the save, it will be saving that. So after you save this one, you need to just connect to the from your SQL studio management. So you can go to the here. can like open this your studio management. Open. So once you open your SQL Studio server management, so click on the connect. So here you need to select the database engine and the server name. Server name will be, so your CRM, this is your CRM URL and comma, you need to give this port number. Always this will be the same for every environment. So 5558. And if you have like a you need to select the authentication type as a Azure Active Directory password. If you have enabled the multi-factor authentication, you need to select this Azure AD Active Directory with universal MFA. So in my case, I haven't enabled the MFA. So I'm selecting this one. And you have to give your CRM username and you have to give the password. So once you give, it will connect to the your CRM online database. Now we can see it's connected to the CRM online database or CDS. It's connected here. So now you can expand your databases. And you can see here, this is my CRM online database. So you can see this, all the tables, what the CRM online database table structure and everything, you can see it here. So here you can see this table structure on the all the tables here. Now, if you want to execute the new query, so click on the new query. So I just execute some sample query. Now you can see like I have executed that select star from account. I'm just selected the account data and it is retrieving these values, right? So like this, we can execute this DSL queries from CDS. So this approach is having some limitations. Let me explain that what are the limitations as of now with the preview version. At present, we have the limitations with that. The tables, all the tables is not enabled for this querying purpose. The tables like auditing, plugin trace logs is not available for querying. And as per the Microsoft documentation, all the field data types is not available for this querying, like a binary, image, entest, SQL variant. Okay, like a file, XML, party list, these all like it's not available for the queries. And other functionality, which is like a CTE, it can be added in the future. And if you can log in as a CRM, and it will take it to your CRM security, whatever the entities you can have the access, those entities only you can able to do the query here. And other thing, that's maximum 2 minutes timeout that still is exist here in the SQL query. Thank you so much for watching this video.